our souls. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. The honorable priesthood of the diaconate in Christ, and for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this country, its president, for all civil authorities, and for the armed forces, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and countryside, and for the faithful dwelling in that, let us pray to the Lord. And for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by land, by sea, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorating our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos, ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other in all our life unto Christ our God. For unto thee are you all glory, honor, and worship. Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Incense we offer to Christ God, for the odor of spiritual fragrance received upon us in the altar. Send down upon us the treasure of divine grace and thine own Holy
Spirit. Lord, hear me. Receive the voice of my prayer and my call. Thank you.
wonderful the evening may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord. An angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. Pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord. Let us ask.
Holy, O Lord.
Commemorating our most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, Never Virgin Mary of all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other in all our life unto Christ our God.
Holy, O Lord.
For thou art a good God and lovest mankind, glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
And to our spirit.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord.
And submissively incline their necks, awaiting not help from man, but entreating thy mercy, and looking confidently for thy salvation. Guard them at all times, both during this present evening and in the approaching night, from every foe, from all adverse powers of the devil, from vain thoughts, and from evil imaginations. For blessed and glorified be the might of thy kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
God, according to thy great goodness, we pray thee, hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for our Metropolitan Tikhon, for our Archbishop Mark, and for all of our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for this country, its president, for all civil authorities, and for the armed forces.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the blessed and ever memorable Holy Orthodox Patriarchs, and for the blessed and ever memorable founders of this Holy Church, and for all of our fathers and brethren, the Orthodox, who departed this life before us, who here and in all the world lie asleep in the Lord.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, remission of sins of the servants of God, the faithful of this holy temple, and all Orthodox Christians of true worship who live and sojourn in this community.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for those who bring offerings and do good works in this holy and all venerable temple, for those who labor and those who sing, and for all the people here present who await thy great and rich mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For thou art a merciful God, and lovest mankind, and unto thee we send the glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Archbishop of Myra and Nicaea, of the martyr Andrew the General, and those who suffered with him, whose memories we keep this day, and of all the saints that have shone forth in this North American land, and of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, have mercy on us and save us, for as much as he is good, and he loves mankind. Spirit. Amen. S praznikom. Keep high the feast day. I think it was a couple of weeks ago when we were here on a Wednesday night in the middle of a terrible storm. And it reminded me so much about how we understand the church as an ark and as a ship which brings us to salvation. The church is also seen as a harbor for the tempest-tossed. You know, those of you that read the email I sent out today realize that, you know, we're still going through a little bit of a storm, but this is nothing new. This is a part of our life in this side of paradise, the faithfulness of God and our desire to be united with him always needs to be undeterred. We know that right now there's so much going on in our world with
what's going on in Afghanistan. I'm sure we're all so shocked by some of the things that we saw on the news. And then also our brothers and sisters in Haiti who are suffering right now. So it always helps to put things into perspective, to look around, and then also to hear about the lives of the saints. And today we heard and celebrated a service to St. Andrew Stratelates, which is just a fancy word, or just a normal word in a different language, for the general. St. Andrew the General, who obviously had the rank of general. He was a Syrian by birth and served under the Emperor Maximian as a secret Christian. He wasn't baptized, and yet before he went into battle, he was very selective about the people that he selected, who he chose to serve in his army. He would gather them together, and he would pray with them and ask for deliverance and health and safety through the name of the one true God, Jesus Christ. And he was, by all accounts, a very successful general. But as it happened, there were people that were jealous of him, and they ratted him out. And when Andrew found out that his supervisor was going to be coming after him, he fled with his army of over 2,000 men. Did he flee someplace so that he can avoid being martyred? No. He fled because he said, if I'm going to die a martyr, I want to be baptized first. And so he sought out a holy bishop named Peter. And he and his men were baptized. And then when the rest of the army came after him, they gladly accepted the charge of being a Christian. And it says in the life that none of the martyrs, St. Theodore and the over 2,000 who suffered with him, even tried to fight back against those who were condemning them and that were trying to harm them. They were so confident in their faith in Jesus Christ that not even the fate of martyrdom shook them. Now, I hear that and I think to myself, I'm not sure if I've got that type of strength. I know in many cases much smaller things shake me. However, I do know that through Jesus Christ, people who consider themselves weak become strong. And it's through the witness of the martyrs, it's through the witness of our brothers and sisters, even today, that we see struggling in beautiful ways within our own community and in our own midst, that we are encouraged to also fight our own good fight, to live our little martyrdom, whatever it happens to be, and to keep everything in a holy perspective. So I'm glad that we're here tonight to sort of be reminded of that sanity that we have in Jesus Christ, to continue to keep our eyes firmly focused on him, that with St. Andrew and all the saints, and especially with the Mother of God, whose dormition we celebrate today, we too might enter the kingdom of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory to Jesus Christ. Just a quick update. Sue Demchak is home from the hospital. She came home yesterday, and she and I spoke today, and she's really thankful, continues to be thankful for your prayers and your calls, your cards, and all of those things. So Sue, if you're watching tonight, just know you continue to have our love and our prayers. As I mentioned in the parish email, the services and events will continue this week. So on Saturday, Vespers will be at 5 p.m., but liturgy on Sunday will be outside, weather permitting. I think we have the people that can do the audiovisual, and I'm sorry, you won't get a break from me. I will still be here this Sunday. You won't get Father Leonid. Such is life. Thanks be to God for all things. Through the prayers of our Holy Fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God.